I'm Micah Smith, and this is Automation Anywhere Quick Tips. In this quick tip, we're going to take a look at the string variable type, and we're going to talk about what it is, where we would use it, and how it can be used with some of our different packages. So first off, what is a string, right? A string is used for storing text-based data. So a first name is a good example of a string. A last name is a string. Maybe someone's address is a string, a city, a state, right? Any of that text-based data or those text-based constants are a good example of using a string data type from within your bot. Now, how do we actually create these strings and where are they used? Well, first off, I'm in my Automation Anywhere Enterprise A2019 control room. Typically, this is what it looks like when you log in. Your actions pane shows up on the left-hand side. Your flow view shows up here. I don't have anything in this bot, so no hidden tricks here. I'm gonna go up to my variables and I'm gonna hit the variable button, and it's gonna expand this accordion so I can see what's going on here. And I'm gonna click the plus button, right? And here we can see that it defaults the type to a string, but there's lots of different variable types that we can create. Numbers, date, time, boolean, file, credential. We'll get into all of those later, but for right now, we're just gonna focus on strings. So I'm gonna leave string as the selected type. It's really important to make sure that you get that part correct, because you could call your variable one thing, but the data type is actually something totally different. Now, speaking of calling our variable something, in Automation Anywhere Enterprise A2019, a best practice for naming is to prefix your variable with a lowercase value representing its type. So for strings, that would be a lowercase s. Now, I'm going to name my variable using camel case naming, which means that each word is going to start with a capital letter and then be followed by lowercase letters. So let's do first name, right? So that's technically called the Hungarian naming format, but it's a lowercase value to prefix my data type. It's camel case naming for each word, right, being capitalized followed by lowercase letters. Now, I can give my first name a description here, whatever I want. Variable to hold user's first name, okay? But again, when we think of these variables, if you're not familiar with variables, a variable is really, think of a reference to a specific piece of data, right? So I'll call the reference s first name, but when I use it within my bot, it's going to actually refer to whatever data is stored inside of that variable. And so in this case, we don't have a value that's been set. The default value is left as empty. I'm gonna fill that in. So I'm gonna put Dan, right? Our first name is Dan. And what that means is that when I reference that variable of s first name within my bot, Dan is the value that's gonna come out, right? So if I wanted to write out the variable s first name to an Excel spreadsheet, right? The Excel spreadsheet would actually have the word Dan in it because I've referenced that variable, and whatever's in the variable is what gets written to the spreadsheet. Not the name of the variable itself, but the reference, which is that Dan value. All right, let's create one more variable. Let's call this one s last name. Again, we'll confirm that string is the data type. We're good on that. I'm gonna fill in a default value again, which is Smith. It's not common that you would fill in default values for different variables that you're creating. I do it sometimes, but typically those values are gonna come from another application I'm working with, right? Maybe I've gone through a spreadsheet, I've read all of the customer first names and last names, and I've saved those in variables. In that case, I wouldn't need to default a value. I'm just doing it here for demonstration purposes. Cool. So let's go back to the Actions tab now. And in the Actions tab, we can see all of our different packages that have been installed. One specifically we want to look at is this string package. So I'm going to open it up here, and we can see that there's a bunch of different actions that are associated with strings. I'm going to select the one that says assign, and I'm going to drag that over to my flow, right? So right now we have an S first name and an S last name that refers to Dan Smith, and we can also assign values to strings using the assign variable here. So I could say here middle name Samuel, right? In this case, I'm putting Samuel in as the value to assign to, and here I'm choosing my variable, and I'm going to hit the plus sign here to create a new variable. If I select from this list, I can see only the variables that I've actually defined already. I'm going to hit the plus button here to create a new one, and we'll call this S middle name. Cool. So Samuel's our middle name. I'm going to use one more assign action, because I want to put those three together. So anything that I put in the assign text box here that's not a variable will be taken in as a literal. So let's see how that works. I'm going to press F2, or I can press this button right here, and that will allow me to select one of my variables, and I'm going to put in first name. I'm going to put a space. I'm going to press F2 again, and I'm going to select middle name. Again, I'm putting the space because anything that is not a variable is taken in as a literal. I'm going to hit F2 one more time, and then I've got my last name. So now I've just put the first name, the middle name, and the last name together, separated by spaces, kind of like we would normally see them written in a document. I'm going to add those to a new variable, which I'm going to call sfullname. Again, it's a string data type by default because I'm working with the string package. I actually can't even change that because this is the string package already. I'll hit create and select. So now I have a total of 4 variables, right? 2 were having the default value set, which was the first and last name. 1 has the value set from the assign action that we used. And the 4th has the value assigned from reference of the other 3 variables. Let's get a message box going so we can see exactly what that looks like. So here's my, oops, scrolled too far. My message box action, I'm gonna drag that over here. And I'm going to display the first name, the middle name, and I'm just putting these with like regular typing for right now. We're going to fill them in just a second. The last name and the full name. Okay. And then for each of these, again, everything in the message box that is not a variable is going to show up as a literal character. So I'm going to press F2 next to first name, and I'll select the first name. I'm going to press F2 next to the middle name, and I'll select the middle name, and F2 next to the last name, I'll select the last name, and then finally the full name. There we go. Okay. So what that's going to do is it's going to basically have a label and then the value for whatever is in first name, right? So we're going to have the label of first name and then the value that's in first name. I'm going to hit run here. Now, strings are really useful when I'm working with text-based data, but when are strings not appropriate, right? Well, let's look at an example of phone number, right? If I were to store a phone number, should that be a number or a string? So I would store that as a string because I'm going to save numbers for those types of values where I'm performing some kind of numerical calculation on. Maybe I need to see if a person is older than 75 years old to qualify for some benefit, right? In that case, that needs to be stored as a number so that I could do a greater than or less than operator to determine if they qualify. But a phone number, I'm not likely to do any kind of numerical calculations on. I'm not going to add one number to a phone number because that really doesn't make sense. So a phone number is an example of where it's good to use a string to technically store something that looks kind of like a number format. Okay? Storing someone's age, I could store in a string, but it depends on how I'm going to use that, right? If I'm going to use it to perform some kind of calculation or some kind of data check, I want that to be in a number format that's appropriate for being able to perform that calculation. If I'm just storing it, then I'll keep it in a string and it's not going to do anything. All right, if we go back to our bot here, we have first name as Dan, middle name is Samuel, last name is Smith, and then the full name, which is Dan Samuel Smith. Again, those are all filled in from our string variable types. Hopefully you found this quick tip helpful. Be sure to like and subscribe for more Automation Anywhere quick tips. My name is Micah Smith. Go be great.